Good evening.
Namaste.
Vanakkam.
To one and all present over here. How different is this evening.
Indeed, very wonderful. The birds around here tell a beautiful tale.
Yes, you will soon discover as the colors of this event embellish us all together. It's a blessing to see the beautiful audience gathered here.
We roll down a red carpet of welcome to all the dignitaries, our chairman, Sri T. Velshankar, board members, trustees, our principal, vice principals, supervisory heads, parents, invitees, well-wishers, and friends.
I, Sia, with my co-host Ralph, once again welcome you all on behalf of the Vikasa family for the Esperanto Day.
It is rightly said, days are not lost when memories are created.
We assure you that this program shall be full of exuberance and excitement and will create some beautiful memories for all of us.
We acknowledge the presence of our guest of honor, Mrs. Joanna Goldie. We are happy to have you in our midst, ma'am.
It takes a big heart to help and shape little minds.
Yes. A big thank you to our principal, Dr. N.K. Charles, who deserves a big applause for all the steps he takes. Every morning is a surprise, every sunset is a challenge, and each day is a gift. To give the first fruit of the day to the Lord is one of the most valuable ways to show our love to God. So let us invoke God's blessings on all of us through a prayer song. Please rise up for the prayer song.
Over to the school choir for the musical ecstasy. Thank you, friends, for bringing the presence of the Almighty amongst us.
Dance has no barriers. It is something that everyone can feel, everyone can understand, and definitely something everyone can enjoy.
Here comes the dancers to welcome the gathering in their own way.
Performance. Dear audience, give them a huge round of applause. They deserve it.
To recognize the valued presence of the chief guest and the audience, may I invite our principal, Dr. N.K. Charles, to welcome the August gathering.
Chairman of this function, this school, Mr. T. Velshankar, trustees of PSS Foundation, governing board members of the Vikasa schools, well-wishers, parents, grandparents, and all the dignitaries who are gathered here this evening, the luminaries to enlighten or light up this evening's program. My dear colleagues and students, it's indeed a happy moment for us to present yet another program for this on this play platform. We were having a series of programs from June onwards, and the Esperanto by class 1 and 2 students is exclusively designed and tailor-made for you for this evening. And I take this opportunity to welcome you all for this program, especially the chief guest for this evening, Mrs. Joanna Goldie, the headmistress Johnson Nursery and Primary School, Tuticorin. We welcome her into our midst with our folded hands with warm greetings. Before I could ask somebody to introduce her to the audience, I would like to ask, leave a thought for you, food for thought. How many of us gathered here would wish that our children should be the best in the world? If I ask a show of hands, everybody would say, I want my child to be the best in the world. Yes, it's true. It is indeed true. That every one of us aspire to be the best in the world, and every one parent who are gathered here or anywhere would wish their children to be the best in the world. There was a little boy who joined a school, and he's been in the school, and the first day of the school, when he went to the school, he was going on disturbing the class. He was going on tapping on the desk, and the teacher said, "What are you doing? Don't do it." And for some time he'll tie the hands, and after some time passes, again he starts tapping on the table, desk, everywhere. And one teacher came and said, "Look, I don't want you to tap anymore on the desk and disturb the classes. So keep your hands behind your back and sit on the chair so that you don't have the temptation of tapping and disturbing the class." He tried to keep his hands behind and sat on the hands for some time. But slowly one hand came up, the other hand came up, again involuntarily started tapping. It was going on, and everybody were wondering, what is this boy up to? The teachers couldn't find, the others could not find the way out. Then there came an experienced person, and he said, "Look, let me talk to him." And he went and said, "My dear boy, you know you are doing very good drumming on the desk. Have you ever tried to beat the drums?" "Drums? No, I never tried." "Why don't you try? Come to my office, I'll give you something." And he called him to the office, and he gave two pairs of drums, sticks. And he started looking at these sticks, and he wanted to know what best could be done. And his name is I keep forgetting the name. It's slightly difficult to remember, but Clint Pulver. His name is Clint Pulver. So this man called him and said, "Clint, come to my office, I'll give you the drumsticks." And he gave a pair of drumsticks. And Clint came back. He was so happy. So instead of tapping on the desk, he started tapping on the drum set at home, at everywhere. Wherever he saw a place, he could do the drums, rhythming. And then soon he became one of the best drummer in the school, in that area, in that town, in the city, in that country, and he has been recognized as one of the world's best drummer. And everybody is happy because he's the world's best, one of the world's best drummer. But then Clint Pulver says, "I may be the best in the world, but there was somebody behind me who made all the difference, and he has been the best for me in the world. So I may be the best in the world, but there is somebody who has been best for the world." So I leave this thought to you this evening as we are sitting and enjoying this program. Many times we try to identify these tiny thoughts coming onto the stage. May it be the welcome dance, may it be the prayer song, may it be the MCs or the other play that you would see. Sometimes we come across certain talents, some not being able to deliver the dialogues, some very good in the steps. We try to identify and give them the best start, but it takes a long way. So don't get curtailed, don't think that it's the end of the road, or don't say that it has not been taken into consideration. As parents, I want you this evening to make your child the best in the world. You be the best for the world. This Mr. Jensen has been the best for Clint Pulver so that he could be the best in the world. And it's a wish at Vikasa, we want to be the best for the world so that the best in the world comes out from the portals of the Vikasa. With this thought, I welcome you all for this evening's Esperanto, and may you have a wonderful evening. Sit and relax. Thank you for this opportunity.
sir, for your honest welcome address.
May I request our beloved chairman, Sri T. Velshankar, to felicitate our chief guest with the memento and a bouquet.
Guest, Mrs. Joanna Goldie, who has graciously accepted our invitation to join us today.
May I request our Vice Principal, Mrs. Sheila Prem Kumar, to introduce the chief guest to the audience.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to introduce the chief guest of today's function, Mrs. Joanna Goldie, MSc, MEd, MPhil. She is a certified educator and trainer, and her area of expertise is in communication, creative thinking, decision making, leadership, to name a few skills. Her achievements have been many, and she has received numerous awards from various organizations, including Junior Chamber International India, Toastmasters International, and Spark Organization. Mrs. Joanna Goldie is a distinguished postgraduate in computer science education and philosophy. She has passed out of Holy Cross Anglo-Indian Girls Higher Secondary School, Tuticorin, and from Annamal College of Education for Women, Tuticorin, where she did B.Ed., M.Ed., and M.Phil. With an illustrious career spanning over 15 years, she serves as the esteemed headmistress of Johnson Nursery and Primary School, Tuticorin. Her unwavering dedication to the field of education has been instrumental in nurturing and shaping accomplished students. With a rich repertoire of self-development topics, she conducts enlightening training sessions that have benefited numerous academic institutions, social organizations, and individuals. To sum up, Mrs. Joanna Goldie stands as a true luminary, a multi-talented individual driven by a profound commitment to education, empowerment, and societal progress. She is married to Mr. Resington, Director, Can Do Automation, Industrial Automation Consultant. Her daughter Rihanna is currently doing her 12th standard, and she has been awarded the national level second place in National Space Challenge Competition conducted by ISRO. Our chief guest is a remarkable personality whose achievements are a source of pride for our community. I wish to express my gratitude to her for being here, and we are honored to have her in our midst today. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Do you like riddles?
Riddles? Yes, I am good at it.
Okay then, give a try and guess the fairy tale. A princess was transformed into a frog. She can't catch flies to save her life, and kisses haven't worked either. The only way to break the spell is by killing the ogress.
Is it Ivan and Princess Nadia?
Absolutely right.
Wow, that's a beautiful tale. Are the kids going to enact it?
Yes, the Vikasa School proudly presents the play Ivan and Princess Nadia.
The story begins like this. The Tsar wants his three sons to get married. As he was growing too old and weak, he creates a test to help them find their brides. The king tells each prince to shoot an arrow. According to the king's rule, each prince would find his bride where the arrow lands. The youngest son's arrow is picked up by a frog. The king assigns his three daughters-in-law various tasks, such as weaving a dress and baking bread. In every task, the frog far outperforms the other two daughters-in-law. Still, the young prince is ashamed of his frog bride to be introduced to others in the palace. He comes to know that the frog bride is Princess Nadia, the most beautiful and wise. And she is transformed into a frog because of the evil spell cast by a cruel ogress. How did the frog come out of the evil spell? What happened to the ogress in the end? Did Ivan and the frog live happily together? Stay tuned as the story unfolds before you.
முன்னொரு காலத்தில் ஒரு அரசர் தனது மூன்று மகன்களுக்கும் திருமணம் செய்து வைக்க விரும்பினார். ஏனெனில் அவர் மிகவும் வயதானவராகவும் பலவீனமாகவும் இருந்தார். அரசர் இளவரசர்களின் வாழ்க்கை துணையை கண்டுபிடிக்க ஒரு சோதனையை கூறி ஒவ்வொரு இளவரசர்களையும் ஒரு அம்பை எய்ய சொல்கிறார். மன்னரின் விதியின்படி ஒவ்வொரு இளவரசரும் அம்புகள் விழுந்த இடத்தில் தங்களது மணமகளை கண்டறிந்தார்கள். ஆனால் இளைய மகனான ஐவன் இளவரசனின் அம்பு மட்டும் ஒரு தவளை மீது பாய்ந்தது. அரசர் தனது மூன்று மருமகள்களையும் ஆடை நெய்தல், ரொட்டி சுடுதல் போன்ற பணிகளை செய்யுமாறு தனது மகன்களிடம் கூறுகிறார். ஒவ்வொரு பணியிலும் மற்ற இரண்டு இளவரசிகளை விட தவளை மட்டுமே தனது பணிகளை சரியாக செய்கிறது. இளவரசனான ஐவன் தனது தவளை மணமகளை அரண்மனையில் மற்றவர்களுக்கு அறிமுகப்படுத்த வெட்கப்படுகிறான். பின்பு புத்திசாலியான பேரழகியான இளவரசி நாடியாதான் மந்திரத்தால் தவளையாக மாற்றப்பட்டார் என்பதை இளவரசன் ஐவன் அறிந்து கொண்டான். தீய மந்திரத்திலிருந்து தவளை இளவரசி விடுபட்டாரா, தூணிக்காரிடம் இருந்து மீட்கப்பட்டாரா? இளம் இளவரசனும் தவளை இளவரசியும் சேர்ந்து மகிழ்ச்சியாக வாழ்ந்தார்களா என்பதை மேடையில் காண்போம்.
கஹானி குச் இஸ் தரஹ ஷுரு ஹோதி ஹை. ராஜா சாஹ்தா ஹை கி உஸ்கே தீனோ புத்ரோ கி ஷாதி ஜல்த் கர் தி ஜாய், கியூகி वह बूढ़ा और कमजोर हो रहा था। वह अपने पुत्रों को तीर चलाने को कहता है और यह भी कहता है कि जहां भी तीर गिरेगा वहीं से उनकी पत्नी लाई जाएगी। छोटे राजकुमार का तीर एक मेंढक पर जा गिरता है। राजा तीनों बहुओं को विभिन्न कार्य सौंपता है और हर बार मेंढक सफल हो जाता है। फिर भी राजकुमार को अपनी मिंडक दुल्हन को महल में दूसरों से मिलवाने में शर्म आती है। कुछ दिनों बाद उसे पता चलता है कि मिंडक दुल्हन सबसे सुंदर और बुद्धिमान राजकुमारी नादिया है और वो एक क्रूर नरभक्षक के जादू के कारण मिंडक में बदल गई है। मिंडक दुष्ट जादू से कैसे बाहर आया? आखिरकार नरभक्षक का क्या हुआ? आगे क्या होता है? आइए देखिए मंच पर।
Once upon a time, there was a kingdom ruled by a Tsar. The Tsar had three sons
and all of them were very handsome and talented. The oldest prince was Prince Gavin. The second oldest was Prince Nicole, and the youngest prince was Prince Ivan. All the three were good at horse riding, hunting, and archery.
Great job, my talented sons.
Thank you, dear father.
Now you all have grown up and are extremely talented. I am getting old and I would like to see you all married. It's time for each of you to find a suitable partner.
If that is your wish, father, then give us your blessings.
Who would you like us to marry?
Father, you have always given us the best. Whoever it is, you show us the bride. We are ready to obey your command.
Oh well, I know all of you are good in archery. Now each one of you must take an arrow and go out into the open field. You must shoot the arrows and wherever they fall, there you will find your bride.
Yes, father, we will obey your command.
The three sons went to the open field. The elder son's arrow fell in a boyar's courtyard, where he saw the boyar's daughter. The second son's arrow fell in a rich merchant's yard, where stood a sweet-looking girl, the merchant's daughter. The third son, Ivan, had the ill luck to send his arrow into the middle of a swamp, where it was caught by a croaking frog.
Yeah.
Where is my arrow? Where did it fall?
Excuse me, young man. Are you looking for this arrow?
Yes. Give me back my arrow.
I will, if you marry me.
What? What do you mean? How can I marry a frog?
You must, for I am your bride. Have you forgotten your father's words?
Yes, but...
Do not worry. Take me to the palace. I am no lesser than your brother's wives.
The three weddings were celebrated. The eldest son was married to the boy's daughter, his middle son to the merchant's daughter, and the poor Ivan to the frog.
After some days,
you are all happy and doing good.
Yes, Father.
Now, I want to see which of your wives is the better little woman. Let them each make me a shirt by tomorrow morning.
Yes, Father.
Your head, Ivan. What is it that troubles you? Was that anything disagreeable in the palace?
Disagreeable indeed. My father wants you to make him a shirt by tomorrow morning.
Do not grieve, Ivan, but go to bed, for morning is wiser than evening.
Skin and turns into Princess Nadia, the wisest and the most beautiful, a maiden far beyond compare.
Come, my maids. Make me a shirt by tomorrow morning, like those my own father used to wear.
Thank you.
take this shirt, Ivan, and go to the palace. I'm sure the Tsar will like it.
Thank you. But how was this possible?
I will not let you down. At any cost, Ivan, hurry up to the palace. The Tsar will be waiting for you.
Welcome, my sons.
Father, we have brought you the shirt that you have asked for.
This shirt will only do for a poor person to wear. Take it away. This shirt will only do for a merchant.
Wow! Wonderful! This is the shirt to be worn by a Tsar.
Thank you, Ivan. I have never worn a shirt like this before.
It seems we were wrong to laugh at Ivan's wife. She is not a frog, but an ogress.
Now, let your wives bake me a loaf of bread by tomorrow. I want to know which of them is the best cook?
Yes, Father.
Why are you so sad, Ivan?
You are to bake a loaf of bread for my father by tomorrow morning.
Do not grieve, Ivan, but go to bed, for morning is wiser than evening.
It is not possible for a frog to make a shirt that satisfies the king.
How can a green frog make a better shirt than us?
I think she must have a secret.
Why don't we ask Eliza to go and see how the green frog bakes the bread, and then we will copy her.
Eliza, go to the green frog's kitchen and see how she bakes the bread. Return soon and tell me the recipe.
Yes, ma'am.
We'll go and tell the recipe for a bitter bread, but sure, not for a better one. I have duped them.
The maid went and told the princesses about the green frog's recipe. Meanwhile, the frog changed into Princess Nadia and called the little bakers to help her to make a tasty bread for the Tsar.
Come, my little bakers. Make haste and set to work. By tomorrow morning, bake me some soft bread, the kind I used to eat at my own father's house.
Hello.
how bread is baked. Only in Fairyland one can find such marvelous loaves. It is adorned with yummy toppings. Thank you, Froggy.
Take this and give to the Tsar Ivan. He will be pleased.
Welcome, my sons.
Father, we have brought you the loaf of bread that you have asked for.
Let me have a look at it one by one. This bread is only fit to be eaten by the slaves. And this one by the maids. Wow, this smells good. This is the bread to be served for the Tsar.
Thank you, Father.
Now, my dear sons, the time has come to introduce my sons and daughters-in-law to the people in the kingdom. Let's join in the celebration. Come well dressed as couples.
Yes, Father.
Why are you so sad, Ivan? Is that your father has grieved you by an unkind word?
How can I help being sad? The Tsar has ordered me to bring you to his feast. And how can I show you to the people?
Do not grieve, but go to the feast alone, and I will follow later. When you hear a great tramping and thundering, do not be afraid. But if they ask you, say that my Froggy is riding in her box.
So Ivan went to the feast alone, and his elder brothers came with the wives, who were all dressed up in their finest clothes and had their brows blackened and roses painted on their cheeks.
Why have you come without your wife? You could have brought her in a handkerchief.
Where did you find such a beauty? You must have searched at the swamps for her.
Where is your wife, Ivan? It's already getting late. Let's start the celebration.
Thank you.
honest folk. That is only my froggy riding in her box.
Is that Ivan's wife? She is adorable. I heard he married a frog. Then how come?
Sorry if I'm late.
Froggy, is it you? I can't believe you are gorgeous.
Yes, I'm Princess Nadia.
Yes, yes. I have heard a lot about Princess Nadia, the most beautiful and the cleverest.
The ogress of the north was jealous of my beauty and cast an evil spell on me. I can be myself only for an hour and the rest of my life as an ugly frog.
But is there any way to come out of the spell?
Yes. My life is in the hands of the ogress of the north now. She doesn't like anyone being more beautiful or cleverer than her. She will do anything to keep herself young and beautiful. Only her last breath can heal me.
I can get rid of the ogress and I will free you from the evil spell cast on you. I cannot leave you. You are mine.
Thank you, Ivan. Take this golden bird along with you. It will show you the way to the ogress's hut. Ah, my body aches. I think the hour has come for me to turn into a frog. Let me leave the place.
Ivan, along with the golden bird, left the palace. Days and months passed. He was tired, but not discouraged. Finally, he reached the ogre's house. He hid behind a large pot. At daybreak, he saw the ogress coming out of the house.
I can smell young, fresh blood. Who is that at my place?
I am Ivan, young of years and old of wisdom.
What made you come here, Ivan?
I have heard people say that you are the most beautiful and the wisest on earth. But you don't seem so. You have wrinkles on your face.
What? Do I have wrinkles on my face?
Yes, but there's nothing to worry about it. I know the secret of being young all time. I have been doing it for many years. That's why I am called Ivan, young of years and old of wisdom.
Yes, yes. You look very young and handsome, young man. I think you must be tired of the long travel. Why don't you and your bird take rest in my hut? By that time, I will ask my maid to make some dragon soup for you.
Thank you, young lady.
Ivan, what is the secret of keeping oneself young all the time?
It's quite a difficult task. I think you cannot do it as you are aged.
Please tell me, Ivan. I'm ready to do anything to keep myself young.
Ask your maid to bring 3 cauldrons. The first one should be filled with olive oil. The second one with ice cold water, where I will sprinkle the magic potion which removes all the wrinkles on your face. And the third with steam hot boiling water that cleanses your skin and makes you white as snow.
The ogress ordered the maid to do as Ivan had asked for. Soon, all three cauldrons were ready.
The olive oil is ready. Let me pour the magic potion into the ice-cold water. Are you sure the water is boiling?
Yes, it is bubbling and seething.
Let me see for myself. Yes, it is boiling. The steaming hot water will actually make you glow and stay young. It is a painful process, but you ought to bear it.
Ha ha ha! I can do anything to keep myself young.
Now jump into the first cauldron.
It is not a difficult task for an ogress like me.
Now, jump into the second cauldron.
I feel very cold.
Don't worry. One more to go. You will feel the warmth and freshness when you jump into the third one.
That is the end of the wicked ogress. Let's hurry up to the palace. Nadia will never be a frog again. You can live happily with her. The ogress has lost breath. We'll break the evil spell cast on her. Let's leave the place.
Nadia, are you all right? The ogress of the north is no more. The evil spell cast on you is broken now. You will never turn into a frog again.
Thank you, Ivan. I am so blessed to be your princess.
Let us celebrate this special day. Ladies and gentlemen, join in the celebration.
Thank you.
live happily ever after.
Performers who rock the stage.
Wise words come from wise people.
Yes, rightly said. Now I would like to invite our chief guest to enlighten us with her thoughts and experiences.
A pleasant evening to one and all gathered here. So what a radiant performance by the little ones, right? So I would like all the parents to please give a loud applause to all the students. It was really a wonderful event to see. It was so colorful and vibrant. I can see the strenuous effort of all the teachers, what pain they have taken to teach your children, right? So shall we give a very big applause for the teachers also? And a great synergy by the parents. So without your cooperation, definitely this would not have happened. So let us all applaud for ourselves, for all the parents also. See, before could like to give some advice or anything, I thought I can share a few of my thoughts or even experience what I went through. So can anyone say which is the most expensive thing in the world? I think Josephana, konjam light on pannunga audience pakkamo. I want to see the audience. Yes. Can anyone give some answer? What is the most expensive thing in the world? Pardon? Diamond? Good. Time? Very good. Pardon? The smile on your kid's face. Wonderful answer. Anything else? So before that, can I converse completely in English or both Tamil and English? Both or Tamil or English? English, fine. So the most expensive thing, right? Nothing is more expensive than a missed opportunity. If you have missed an opportunity, that's it. So nothing is more expensive than a missed opportunity. This pre-primary year is your child's crucial years. It is a phase where the children are full of with wonders, curiosity, experiences. So you know what is the right thing to be with the children is to be present with the students. Be present with your children. If you miss this opportunity, you're not going to gain anything. So always be present, more than material possession, more than materialistic things. Your presence your child needs now. Sometimes we go out, we have some shopping or anything. What is the first thing the parent does? What is the first thing the parent does when a parent is taking the child along with them to the shopping? They give the phone to the children's hand. They give the phone to the child's hand. You be busy, I'm also busy. Don't disturb me. You're missing your child's nature. This is the time where the child is very curious to learn more and more. They're just like a sponge. They try to soak up the values, experiences, knowledge from the world. And the world is none other than you. You are their world. They try to soak up all the knowledge, values, and experiences from you. But you are missing being with them. I would like to share a real life story. When my daughter was around 13 years old, once I was just screwing my earring, it just dropped. The screw dropped. So we know, right? We usually feel lazy to bend down and see. So, okay, but anyway, till then, we were just looking into it, but couldn't find. So instantly, she had an idea. All know you have a remote car, right? You know a remote car. The children will know. She placed the mobile with the camera on, video on, and she started having the remote in her hand. She was doing, and she's searching under the cot. Bed. That idea was good. Now, as a parent, it is my duty to encourage that curiosity. So that made her to immediately interlink with the then news what happened. Hope you would have heard about the news, right? Around 10 to 12 boys in Singapore, they went for trekking. They were caught up under a cave or something like that, and they were not able to come out. So the people felt very difficult to find out them, because they are not able to go inside and search for it. So immediately, during her project, she explained, why don't we send such kind of, maybe it can be scrutinized little more, but the idea the child is linking with the curiosity. So this we should not miss in the child. To say, she's very much anxious in science now. That is what even the vice principal ma'am was saying. She actually received a national second place in National Space Challenge, which was conducted by ISRO. This is what the parents, as a parent, what we can do. So always try to be present with your child. And one more thing I like is, in abroad, you would have seen in the movie also, reading books. Parents will read books to their children. Actually, it's a very good habit. It's not only you have a very good communication or very good rapport with your child, but also you instill the love for book and reading. There starts a very good communication. Why? The child will be very curious. Thank you. The child will be very curious. What is this? What happened to that person? Why did this happen like this? The child starts asking questions. And there, the parents has a space to answer the child. And you can relate what is happening in day-to-day life. Usually, whenever the child goes home, the parents will ask, what happened today? What happened in school today? Please do not start your conversation like this. It will be usual, and the child will get bored, because always child likes to learn new things from you, since you are the world for them. And you keep repeating the same question, what happened today in school? Try to have a conversation with the open communication with such kind of stories. Through stories, you can teach moral values and ethical values to your child. Nowadays, the book reading has been, my personal perspective, I feel it's declining. So I want more students to read more and more books. The more you read, the the better place you are. So always, as a parent, so read together and encourage their curiosity. And always try to have a very good learning environment in the house, because home is a very good place for learning. You are the most and best influential teachers for your child. Or don't try to fill up the house or their places with unwanted things which they are rarely using. Try to have some educative material, books, or some hand-on activities, or motivating pamphlets, or posters, or something like that. Maybe it seems to be dramatic, but this is all what I am following personally. That is what I am sharing to you. I am seeing lots of changes in my child. The more I concentrate on her, I am respecting her individuality. I am nurturing her individuality. That's very, very important. More than respecting, you have to nurture the individuality. Each child is unique, as you all know very well. Respect them. Let them be as they are. Bring them up in that. And one more thing. When you are having that reading, learning environment in your home, at your home, the parent bond is very tight. Because my brother, his son is around just 6 years old. He is in US. When comparing to our child, I took him and went to a shop, toy shop, to get a toy for him, and I took and went one of my cousin's son. So I told them, you can choose any toy, it is your wish, because I'm just going to give you a reward. Since you have been very good, so I'm going to give you a reward. Both the children chose the gift. So where the child which is living here in India has chosen a gift which can be played by a 13 years old, but the child is around 6 years old. But my brother's child, he is 6 years old. As soon as the shopkeeper, he picked up the toy, his next question was, even I said, okay, because I did not see, it didn't come to my mind. He immediately asked, 6 years old child, he's asking the shopkeeper, is it 6 plus? The question. Is it 6 plus? Okay, 6 plus. Then I can play with it. How come this is happening? Because the parents talk. Without the parents talking, this cannot happen. We always, and most probably you would have seen, always the father and mother, they themselves will have some conflicts during the children's education. What will the father say? It is your job. As a mother, you only have to look after the child. That is your job. My job? What is the father's job? I will leave, drop in the school. I'll give the lunch. I'll pick him up and come. This is the father's job. Both of them are equally helping each other. But most probably, even for the parents-teachers meet, you see, all the mothers will flock together. Fathers will be missing. Because they don't know who's the class teacher. First and foremost, as a parent, as being a father, please try to know who is your child's class teacher. What is her name? And who are the friends seated beside your child? Right, left, front, and back. Which child is seated there? Until then, we will not be involved in the child. Only then, through the child's friend, we will know what is our daughter or what is our son. So always try to be present and be very encourage the curiosity among the children, and nurture their individuality and always try to create a very good learning environment at home. Start from the home. And when these all club together, you'll have a very good open communication to your child. A very good open communication to your child you will have. And finally, so far, you've all been a guiding star in their lives. Right? You've been a guiding star in their lives. And let's still make each memories of them count. Please remember, once you miss an opportunity, it's never coming back. Nothing is more expensive than a missed opportunity. தவறவிட்ட வாய்ப்பை விட விலை மதிப்பானது எதுவுமே இந்த உலகத்தில் இல்லை. Please try to understand parents before it's too late. Please do not miss our children. Let us be with us and try to hug them always. Always try to have a physical contact with your children. Always try to have a physical contact. Try to hug them. Say that you always love them. It may be dramatic. It may be dramatic because I do always. Always have a group hug. Father, mother, children, always have a group hug. How many of you will kiss your daughter or son daily? Can you put up your hands? Wonderful. Good. That's nice. How many of you will say that I love you? Nice. Beautiful. Lovely. I want everyone to put your hands up saying that. Say always, more than I love you, say I trust you. That gives them more emotion, more happiness among your child. So more than I love you, say them, I trust you. So the child should always know, my parent is always there for me. She is always right beside me. So I can do wonders. I can trust anyone. I can do wonders. So always, please always don't forget, try to have a physical touch with your child. Your father, mother, and the son or daughter. Always have a group hug and say kiss and say love you and I trust you. This I still follow, though my daughter is 17 years old. We still follow at home. That is what I said. I don't want to give you an advice, but I would like to share my experience. What I have enjoyed, I want you also to enjoy it. So please don't forget the one thing where I started. Nothing is more expensive than a missed opportunity. Thank you so much. Thank you for the wonderful opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am, for your enriching and thought-provoking message.
The evening is lovely, dark and deep, but we have promises to keep and miles to go before we sleep.
Let's make the end of the formal function with vote of thanks, with appreciation and gratitude to those who made this evening a grand success.
I request our headmistress, Mrs. Auxilia Fernando, to render the vote of thanks.
A delightful evening to everyone present here. I stand here cherishing the unique privilege bestowed upon me to render my heartfelt gratitude to all the wonderful people gathered here for making today possible. First and foremost, I lift up my heart with grateful thanks to the Lord Almighty for His blessings showered in abundance. We thank you, Father, for your immeasurable and bountiful blessings on every aspect of our function. I feel equally delighted and thrilled to vociferate my thanks to our esteemed chief guest, Mrs. Joanna Goldie, the principal, Johnson Primary School, Tuticorin. Her gracious presence has adorned us today with a remarkable splendor and gaiety and familiar to most of us. Thank you, ma'am, for sparing your valuable time with us this evening. I would like to spell out words of thanks to our respected principal for awakening the desires of young generations, sharpening and harnessing the creative minds. Sir, your action inspires others and you explore the possibilities and help us to reach great heights. Thank you, sir, for being an author of our ambition. I also cherish equal gratitude towards Vice Principal Mrs. Sheila Prem Kumar for her support, guidance, endeavor in every stage of our activities. Special thanks to Vice Principal Academics, Vice Principal Non-Academics, and Supervisory Heads for your motivation and encouragement. We are extremely thankful to all our board members, trustees, dignitaries, special invitees, friends, teachers, well-wishers for their silent inspiration and a sense of appreciation. Collaborative effort is the success of any event, and as such, Vikasa is no exception. I thank all my dedicated team of teachers for their cooperation and support. A special mention of thanks to Mr. Titus for recording, Mr. Chandran for mixing and mastering, which added spice to our play, Mr. Joseph Ravels for light and sound, Mr. Kumar of Madhumanish Studio for photography and videography, Chinnathurai and Seasons Boutique for costumes, Mr. Franklin and Mr. Rysep for helping us with the props. We are indebted to the PT department, student volunteers, members of the non-teaching faculty for their contribution in various aspects of today's event, which made a difference. Thank you for your unflinching support. Vikasa has proved its standard over the years as a reliable source of inspiration, even as it continues to inform, form, and transform its student community. It has been soaring high and touching lives. The credit goes to you, dear parents. Thank you for being the key players in our success story. The essence of the fruit is always tasted at the last. So, I am ever thankful to the blooming buds of class 1 and 2 children who stole the show with their mesmerizing performance. Gratitude costs nothing, but it is a big investment in future. Once again, we renew our gratitude and spread the fragrance of love. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Vikasa has always proven to be a home to us. It has shaped us into beautiful sculpture.
May God shower his blessings on all the people connected with this great institution.
Thank you, everyone, for making this day a memorable one.
It's us, Sia and Ralph, signing off until we meet again next year for another Esperanto Day.
Let's all rise up for the national anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladhi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे।